If you're a diabetic, one common piece of advice you may hear is to cut the carbs. And it's true. Eating less carbs means you'll feel better and keep your sugar under control. But what foods are good if you're counting your carbs? You might know about the more obvious ones, like meat, eggs, poultry, and seafood. They're rich in protein and help you feel full. But did you also know about other unlikely low-carb foods like chocolate? And when it comes to choosing the right foods for your diet, you need to know that not all carbs are created equal. If you want to keep your blood sugar levels nice and even, it's crucial that you know which carbs are good for you and which ones to avoid. So, in this video, we'll reveal the top 10 low-carb foods for diabetics. You'll also discover the truth about simple and complex carbs and which is better, and the optimal amount of carbs for diabetics. But before we continue, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to Diabetics Talk to get the latest and greatest videos from us. All right, let's get on with it. Like I said, not all carbs are the same. So it's important to know which carbs are great for diabetics and which ones wreak havoc on your blood sugar. And that's where simple and complex carbs come in. You might have heard these carb types before, but what are they really? What's the difference between them and which ones are better for you? Well, first of all, it's much easier for your body to process simple carbs, hence the name. And that's not a good thing. What this means is that the sooner your body breaks down those carbs, the quicker your blood sugar rises. So consuming a lot of simple carbs will cause massive spikes in your blood glucose, which is the last thing you want. You'll find simple carbs in things like soda, candy, a lot of breakfast cereals, and pretty much any processed foods with added sugars. In a lot of cases, foods that contain simple carbs have little to no nutrients, and they're basically empty calories. However, there are some exceptions to this. Strangely enough, there are some foods with simple carbs that have a lot to offer, nutrition-wise, and that includes vitamins, minerals, and fiber. But we'll get to more of that in just a bit. Now, you also need to know about complex carbs. Unlike its simpler counterpart, complex carbs take longer for your body to process. So that gives you a steady supply of slow-burning energy and keeps your blood sugar levels stable throughout the day. You'll usually find complex carbs in unrefined or unprocessed foods. The biggest examples are whole grain foods. These are foods that use the entire portion of the grain, using parts that have nutrition and fiber. On the other hand, refined grains tend to use only a portion of the grain. So generally speaking, foods with complex carbs are more nutritionally dense. Okay, so now that we've talked about the quality of carbs, what about the quantity? Is there an ideal amount of carbs for a diabetic? The answer is yes and no. You see, there isn't an exact figure set in stone, and not everyone in the carb counting community agrees on what the ideal amount should be. Here's what I mean. A study in 2005 found that limiting carbs to 20 grams daily significantly lowered blood sugar levels and improved weight management. On the other hand, a different study in 2008 found that 70 to 90 grams also yielded great results. So the truth is that yes, there is an ideal amount of carbs, but only for that person. Everyone processes carbohydrates differently, so what's ideal for someone isn't necessarily ideal for the next person. That said, it's a good idea to consult with a doctor or nutritionist. They can help you come up with a customized carb plan tailored to your needs. Everyone has different goals and baseline levels, so it's better to get a medical professional involved. Now, let's get to our list with the top low-carb foods for a diabetic. Number 10, meats, and eggs. While meat is associated with low-carb diets, it doesn't mean that you can just wolf down a whole slab of beef or bacon all the time. Like all foods, moderation is key, and you should mix it up with other low-carb foods as well. That said, beef has little to no carbs and does a good job of satisfying hunger pangs. Also, you'd best go with grass-fed beef, which is full of micro and macronutrients compared to grain-fed beef. For instance, grass-fed beef has way more healthy fats, not to mention vitamins A, E, B3, B6, and B12. These are all excellent for muscle and cell function, and gives you a nice source of energy without paying the cost of high carbs. Plus, the USDA states that beef has all the essential nutrients necessary for supporting your basic nutritional needs. Other low-carb meat options include chicken, which is loaded with protein, pork and bacon, which, as I said, is okay, but only in moderation, turkey, and organ meats such as liver, which are loaded with iron, protein, vitamin A, and folate. A study published in 2005 in the American Journal of Clinical Nutrition found that low-carb, high-protein meats such as these keep you full for longer periods of time. Meanwhile, eggs are a versatile food that many consider to be nature's perfect food. An egg can be cooked in so many ways. It's packed with nutrients that can help your eyes and brain. A study from the University of North Carolina identified one particular nutrient in eggs called choline. Most people don't know about this, but choline is crucial to building cells in the body and reducing the risk of heart disease and fights inflammation. Number 9, seafood. Fish like salmon, trout, sardines, shellfish, tuna, as well as seafood such as lobster and shrimp are also part of the low-carb club. The most prevalent nutrient among these healthy foods would be omega-3, which is crucial to brain functioning among other things. In fact, omega-3s offer a world of health benefits, such as boosting your mood, improving eyesight, and cutting down the risk of heart disease. A study in 2013 from India linked omega-3 consumption to better heart health. And not only is seafood practically zero carb, they're also chock full of vitamins B12, D, and iodine. So make sure to make room for seafood on your plate during your next meal. Number 8, asparagus. This is a vegetable that's well loved for how versatile it is. It's got only 2 grams of carbs for every 100 grams, which is an excellent ratio. You can enjoy it on its own, or you can eat it with meat or seafood, so you can really stack those health benefits. Like the other foods on this list, asparagus holds its own, being the nutritional powerhouse that it is. For instance, you'll find fiber, which is essential to proper digestion and lowered cholesterol levels. You'll also enjoy a good helping of vitamin C, K, and folate, which form a good foundation for overall immunity. Folate is also excellent in reducing the risk of cancer, dementia, and birth complications. To top it off, asparagus is rich in protein. Researchers from the University of Arkansas found that a protein-rich diet has a positive impact on cardiovascular health, and it's one of your best allies in fighting diabetes. Number 7, kale. Kale is highly regarded as a low-carb superfood, and it's easy to see why. It's very low in calories and rich in fiber, but it's also high in nutrients such as vitamin A, B6, as well as vitamin C and K. According to a nutritional study from Self magazine, you also get a good serving of manganese, calcium, copper, and magnesium. And you only get about 6 grams of carbs for every 67 grams of kale. So you're not only skipping on the carbs big time, but you're also incorporating a massive amount of life-giving nutrients every time you eat kale. Even better is that kale is quite a versatile vegetable. You could put it in a salad, or if you want to have a snack, spray a bit of olive oil on it and bake it into a crunchy chip. It's found in most produce aisles, so check it out the next time you go grocery shopping. Number 6, avocado. This low-calorie, low-carb superfood is a staple for guacamole lovers, but it's also got a ton of health benefits as well. That's largely because it's packed with nutrients in every serving. A study in 2013 documented the content of half an avocado, which is about 68 grams, and it contained essential nutrients such as dietary fiber, potassium, magnesium, vitamin A, vitamin C, vitamin E, vitamin K1, folate, vitamin B6, niacin, and high monounsaturated fatty acids. What all of this means is that you're not just cutting down on your carbs, but you're also getting your fill of nutrients that prevent disease, improve digestion, lower cholesterol, fight cancer, and manage your weight better. Okay, we're halfway through our list of the top 10 low-carb foods for diabetics. But before we proceed, it's time to reveal your 2 free gifts. Discover an entire world of diabetes-fighting foods with our new book, 10 Incredible Foods That Reduce Blood Sugar. Plus, learn the real reasons why type 2 diabetes, cancer, heart illness, dementia, and obesity are increasing at a terrifying rate, and find out what really works when it comes to preventing these illnesses by watching our free 1-hour documentary, The Scary Truth About Sugar. Both gifts are free and waiting just for you. Just click the link in the description below to claim these 2 free gifts. Back to our list. Number 5, strawberries. When it comes to sweet fruits, strawberries are hard to beat. That's because they're low in carbs, and one serving has 11 carbs and 3 grams of fiber, making it 8 net carbs. They're filled with vitamin C, manganese, vitamin B9, and folate. They're also packed with plant-based chemicals that control blood sugar. And they also have antioxidants that reverse cell damage and lower the risk of cancer. A study done in Europe in 2012 looked at the impact of strawberries on human health. And the researchers found that this fruit is excellent for controlling blood sugar and improving cardiovascular health. Strawberries work well in smoothies, in salads, or you can enjoy them on their own. They can also be used in jams, jellies, and healthy desserts. But like all fruits, look for fresh strawberries and avoid anything in a can to avoid unhealthy processed sugars that can spike your blood glucose levels. Number 4, almonds. Most nuts and seeds are good for low-carb dieters. Plus, they're also another food that's versatile. You can snack on them or add them to salads and other dishes. They can also be enjoyed as almond milk or butter for those avoiding dairy in their diet. Just make sure to go with the unsweetened variety to keep your blood sugar levels in check. One serving has around 2 net carbs, but it's filled to the brim with healthy fats, protein, fiber, calcium, potassium, and other nutrients. Research from the University of California shows that consuming almonds increases your antioxidant intake, which in turn protects you from what's known as oxidative stress. This is when cell molecules get damaged from free radicals floating in your system, and that can lead to accelerated aging, inflammation, and even cancer. Better yet, almonds can also help with controlling your blood sugar because of its magnesium content, Studies show that some type 2 diabetics have a magnesium deficiency, so increasing their intake of this essential mineral improved both of their glucose levels and insulin functions. So having a serving of almonds every day goes a long way in protecting your long-term health. Number 3, Greek yogurt. Also known as strained yogurt, this is an excellent low-carb food which happens to offer other health benefits as well. First off, there's way less sugar, and it's loaded with probiotics, which are great for gut health and digestion. Yogurt in general is loaded with helpful microorganisms, which your digestive tract needs to build up your immunity and keep disease at bay. Most people don't know that good immunity starts within the gut, so probiotic-rich foods help out with this immensely. And not only that, a study from UCLA also linked better brain function with good gut bacteria. Greek yogurt also offers a generous helping of protein, which helps build muscle, bones, skin, and other vital organs. And with high protein content also comes better immunity, not to mention more energy to burn throughout the day. Number 2, healthy oils. Another low-carb option are healthy oils. Now, there are a lot of choices when it comes to oils in general, but the ones you want should contain medium chain fats that fall under the monounsaturated category. These types of oils are naturally easier to burn off and will less likely turn into stored fat. And you'll want to avoid highly processed oils that cause inflammation, such as soybean oil, corn oil, and canola oil. So which oils are best though? Well, you can try extra virgin olive oil, which contains healthy fats, which are excellent for cardiovascular health. Nutritional research from Self magazine shows that extra virgin olive oil is mostly made up of monounsaturated fats, which I mentioned earlier. Plus, this type of oil contains oleic acid, which many researchers have linked to fighting cancer. One study from 2006 done at the University of California Davis Medical Center cited oleic acid as an effective anti-inflammatory agent, and that makes it a powerful ally against cancer. Another great healthy oil is coconut oil. It's a low cholesterol oil that contains a lot of antioxidants, and it's pretty popular with the weight loss community. In fact, joint research from Columbia University and the New York Research Center found that medium chain oils like coconut oil led to a greater rate of losing weight. Not only that, those with type 2 diabetes can use coconut oil to manage their blood sugar levels. The American Diabetes Association published a study in 2009, which shows that coconut oil is great at preventing both obesity and insulin resistance. This is crucial because these factors play a huge part in causing and aggravating type 2 diabetes. Aside from these, you can also try other low-carb healthy oils, such as avocado oil, ghee, macadamia oil, unrefined sesame oil, and rice bran oil. All right, and the number one low-carb food for diabetics is dark chocolate. Unlike its highly processed counterparts, dark chocolate has way less sugar and more nutrients that are excellent for diabetics. Dark chocolate is derived from cacao, which happens to be rich in cancer-fighting antioxidants. Consuming this low-carb treat also helps greatly in reducing inflammation, which leads to a lot of health complications if left unchecked. Plus, dark chocolate is great for reducing the risk of heart disease, thanks to a heart-friendly compound called flavanols, and this plays an important role in reducing blood pressure. A 2007 study from Germany shows that moderate cocoa intake has a positive effect on blood pressure. So that means you can enjoy dark chocolate in moderation and protect your health in the process. And now you know the top 10 low-carb foods for diabetics. Which are your favorite? Let us know in the comments below. And don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel. Most of all, don't forget to grab your 2 free gifts. Just click the link in the description below. Thanks for watching and have a healthy day.